Hey everybody, Dr. Shaikh here from The Dentalist. In our last video, we completed chapter 1 of dental material science. And today we're starting chapter 2, which is the properties used to characterize dental materials. If you want to go back and see what we did in chapter 1, go ahead and look for the link somewhere on the screen. You see, a material performs best when it is used at the relevant time. And for that, you got to know your material very well. And for that, you have to have a good knowledge of the properties of the dental material you want to use. So let's learn what properties of dental material are essential for you to know in different situations. Now, how will we know if it's a temporary or a permanent filling material? How will we know if that material can be used as a cavity liner or either a cavity base? What makes an impression material a good impression material? So to keep a track of the properties, we have to look at the properties at different stages or times to know the material pretty well. So here are four different times when you observe your material to know its properties. The time when the material is toured or when it's unmixed. The time while mixing and manipulating the material. The stage during setting of the material. And the properties after the material is set. Now let's talk a little bit more about these times or stages individually so you know what to observe in them. At the time of storage or when the material is unmixed, we look for the shelf life of the material. As there are certain materials that deteriorate after a certain period of time from the date of manufacturing. So always be sure to check the batch number stamped onto the material to be sure about the shelf life, as you don't want your material to crumble when it's in need. By the way, the shelf life is the length of time for which the item remains usable or fit for use. Now, as per manufacturer's instructions, there are some materials whose shelf life can be extended by storing them at the given temperatures, and also decreases if not kept at the temperatures given. Therefore, role of temperature is another important thing to take care of when storing the material. Now, talking about the second stage when you observe the material, that is at the time of mixing or manipulating the material. Manipulation of material basically means the way of handling the material. So at the time of mixing and manipulating, we are actually concerned about the rheological properties of the dental material and how they change from the time of mixing to when the material is about to set. The rheological property of the material is the steady of flow of a material in a semi-solid or liquid state. The form in which the material is supplied is called the method of dispensation. So the components of the material are dispensed in the form of powder and liquid, two pastes, semi-solid or paste and liquid. These components are mixed with each other and are set by a chemical reaction or light that initiates a chemical reaction and takes it towards the set. The way of mixing a dental material is specific for each kind of material and is mostly predefined. So when the components are dispensed in powder and liquid form, their mixing has to be done in a definite proportion and with a definite technique to get reproducible results. The manufacturers of dental materials are taking advancements in the methods of dispensation so that it's easier for the dental assistant or the dentist to get those definite proportions and get more reproducible results. An example of this advancement is the amalgam capsule that has definite proportion of the amalgam alloy and mercury that is placed in the amalgamator, which is a machine that vibrates it with a definite technique to mix the amalgam to produce reproducible results. And there are alginate mixers available to mix alginate with a definite technique to produce reproducible results again. Talking about the two-paste dispensation method, the manufacturer usually gives a good color contrast between the two pastes. So the achievement of a proper mix is judged when the color becomes homogeneous. So the manipulation of every kind of material is different. Most of them should be in a relatively fluid state at the time when we're working on them. And then it should undergo setting that would turn it into a rather rigid or rubbery form. Like what happens with an impression material or a filling material, if you've come across one. So the time available for mixing and manipulating a material is called the working time, which basically tells you the amount of time you can work on the material before it achieves its rigid form. For example, an impression material is placed in the patient's mouth before the end of its working time. Otherwise, if we get late, it proceeds to set. So another important time is the setting time, which is the time taken by the material to reach a certain level of rigidity. Most materials have a definite setting time, and then there are some that have an initial setting time in which they appear to be set, but they actually continue setting for a considerable time and then achieve their final set. The final setting time may be after several hours, and that's when these materials reflect their optimum properties. So to judge these materials at the time of their initial set is not fair to these materials. So basically, the properties that actually matter are after the material is finally set. The properties when the material is toured or during mixing may influence the clinician's preference, but generally, the suitability of the material for a certain application is judged on the basis of its properties when the material is actually set. So to carefully know about the properties of the material after setting, we will divide them into mechanical properties, chemical properties, biological properties, and thermal properties. Okay, we're ending today's session now. I know it was a long one, I'm sorry. Let's just quickly summarize everything. So we started with four different stages to know the properties of the materials. The first one was when the material is toured. Second was when it's being mixed. The third was when it's being set. And the fourth one was when it is actually set. Then we individually studied these times to see what we have to look for in the material at these different stages. And for the rest of the video, just watch it as many times as you want, revise it, and get the hold of this topic. In the next video, we'll talk about the properties of the set material. So be prepared. That's all for today, my friends. This is Dr. Shaikh saying goodbye to you. Take care till we meet again.